Hello everybody, this is Bryan Blackner here. Welcome back to Let's Play from One Glazed. In this episode, we're gonna go through the ice pack. Select favorites or buy one, get one free. Plus, take an additional 40% off all clearance items. Men's Warehouse. Follow your style.
If you are suffering from constipation or irregularity,
a bait back.
Powders may take days.
And everything we ship has something in common. Whether it's expedited overnight, or shipped around the globe, it's handled by OD employees who know they're delivering freight. Means delivering promises.
Fucking bullshit.
OD, helping the world keep promises.
Rejuvenate is the number one selling floor care product at the Home Depot. Rejuvenate's super concentrated formula is the only floor finish that reduces your pores in only one easy mop and application. It fills and scratches.
My internet keeps being a piece of ass.
Finally, at ceramic time. And Rejuvenate's cabinet and furniture store.
Come
on. At the Duralite shine that lasts for years. Rejuvenate is available at these fine retailers or at rejuvenateproducts.com.
My husband is
my internet's probably down or something. I don't know.
America's disabled veterans are not only their family's heroes, but also our heroes.
On September 16, 1969, while serving in Vietnam, the enemy
piece of shit internet.
Pound bomber was rigged as a landmine. I lost my right hand at the wrist and my left arm at the shoulder. There was a point in my life when I wasn't sure that I was going to live. And honestly, I'm not sure that I wanted to live. That, to me, is the darkest point in my life.
Alright, we got another medalist.
For nearly a century, DAV has been supporting our veterans in their time of need, but they need your help.
Your gift, just $19 a month, helps veterans just like my grandpa.
Without the DAV, there is no way that I'd be where I am today. I would never have the opportunity to enjoy my kids, my grandkids.
Just 63 cents a day should let you care about veterans like my grandpa.
There are many others just like me.
Alright, I'll be back, folks.
A theater in England announced that they
guys, I'm back.
Have no dwarves in their Snow White production.
God damn internet, man.
Is too offensive. And so they will call for
production. Yeah, they want to fucking respond.
But they were
I'm starting to get really pissed off over it.
Martin Malley is a loser because he couldn't make more than $1.72 playing guitar on the street. And the winner is Brittany, the last surviving 9/11 search dog.
Let me see something.
This is a Fox News alert. Governor Rick Perry is out. Just moments ago, the former Texas governor announcing he is suspending his campaign. Yes, he is dropping out of the 2016 race for the White House. This marking the end
Game
of his second
glitch.
White House bid. Perry's campaign has been struggling after running out of money. Campaign staffers stopped getting paid. The longest-serving governor in Texas history was stuck polling at near zero.
Right,
and
a
very different story, though, tonight for Dr. Ben Carson, from political outsider to top-tier candidate.
Come on.
Retired neurosurgeon Dr. Ben Carson continues upward surge in the polls. Take a look at this one. A brand-new Quinnipiac University poll putting Dr. Ben Carson in second place with 21% in Iowa.
Only here we get a
Donald polling at 27%.
And nugget.
Perhaps even more impressive, Dr. Carson.
I should explore this cave in the last episode.
And Dr. Ben Carson goes on the record. Good evening, sir.
Good evening, Greta. Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you. Well, there's one less in the GOP field. What do you think tonight about Governor Rick Perry dropping out?
You know, I've gotten to know Rick Perry. He's
fuck
a very
up,
fine gentleman, a great intellect, a very fine person. And I wish him the best. And certainly, if there is a Carson administration, we will certainly be seeking his advice.
Have you had a chance to reach out to him? I know it just happened a short time ago.
No, I haven't had a chance to talk to him yet.
All right, today we went to Ferguson, Missouri. Why did you go to Ferguson?
Ferguson represents something quite unique in America. You know, a couple of years ago, if you'd said Ferguson was here, people would say, "What?" And now virtually everybody knows about Ferguson.
Okay,
and,
just the leader's house.
Represents, because what happened in Ferguson could have happened in any city in America, you know, given the right combination of factors. And I wanted to learn from the people there. What was there to learn? What good came out of that? What were the bad things that came out of that? What can we learn? Because, you know, this is supposed to be a country that is up for and by the people. And I don't think the leadership can provide good leadership without knowing exactly what it is that the people are thinking and what they want.
Well, there you go, everybody. That was the Ice Pass. So I'm just going to end the episode right here. So that's all for this episode of Let's Play Point Glazed. And the next episode. In the next episode, we're going to jump in later. This is Bryan Blackner. I thought you guys watching. I'll see you guys next time.